The Modi government has electrified the stock market by its promise to privatize all non-strategic public sector companies.
Other than IDBI banks, we propose to take up the two public sector banks and one general insurance company in the year 21-22.
Even in strategic sectors like, you know, atomic energy, space, power, defense, telecoms, transport, oil, insurance, banking, coal and minerals, it intends to own just three or four companies in each sector, getting rid of the rest. Now, in simple numbers, the government has promised, therefore, to sell nearly 300 public sector companies. 300 public sector companies. And this could unlock up to $500 billion. Now, that's about 35 to 40 lakh crore rupees of investable resources for the state. No surprise then that the stock market just jumped nearly 10% in less than a week after the budget. It was shocked and it was awed by this ambition. But hold on, all of this is much easier said than done. Remember, in 7 years, the Modi government has not managed to sell even one public sector company, simply because the whole process is fraught with several pitfalls. One, politically, it shall be accused of selling the family silver to big domestic cronies or neo-colonialists. That's, giant Western companies that are modern-day, supposed to be modern-day clones of the East India Company. Two, assets have to be fairly valued, which is a controversial and a subjective process. And it's easily challenged in courts and it's vulnerable to charges of corruption. Often, as with Air India, the overhang of debt makes the whole deal unviable unless the government bites the bullet and waves off, easier said than done, waves off thousands of crores. Or, as with BPCL, some of the strategic assets like the Numaligarh refinery, strategic assets on the balance sheet, they need to be ripped out before the company can be sold. So the net result of all this is that you are not able to do a sale for years on end. Point number three, workers just hate privatization because they fear layoffs, they fear adverse working conditions. Now, it's very critical to get their buy-in, and that can be done with incentives, generous stock options, or voluntary exit packages. Number four, bureaucrats who run this whole process, they simply do not have the skill sets or the competence to pull off a quintessentially market-driven and a complex merger or a complex acquisition. And as always, they are just very highly suspicious of professional talent, and so they never co-opt them in. So, as you can see, it's a gigantic task to sell even five public sector companies in 1 year. But even if I accept this very optimistic accelerated rate of 5 a year, it would take the government 60 years to sell 300 companies. In other words, this whole promise of such a massive privatization, nearly $500 billion, is aborted at birth. It's dead, it's over, it's out. Or, is there another model of privatization that could avoid this deadly pitfall? Can, for instance, public sector companies be privatized without, underline this, without selling a single government share? Believe it or not, yes, we can do it. Now, the clue to this seemingly impossible feat is embedded in the Maruti model of disinvestment, perhaps really the most successful privatization ever. Now, that was done in the early 1980s. Then the government kept majority shareholding. It kept majority shareholding, selling just 26% to Suzuki, Japan's Suzuki. But, underline this, but it gave Suzuki greater control over day-to-day management. Now, over the next decade, through the 80s, the government very slowly transferred over 50% ownership to Suzuki, followed by a public listing, which was underwritten by Suzuki at 2300 rupees per share. Bingo! the government made a tremendous return on investment. So now you can figure out how to do the impossible and privatize 300 banks and 300 companies in under one decade. We can simply begin by selling a minority, underline this, minority stake of 26% to pedigreed corporations or a group of stellar professionals. The government should simultaneously convert its own equity shareholding to 10-year compulsorily convertible preference shares. Those are called CCPS, which are separately listed. Remember that CCPS are considered as equity, are equal to equity under Indian laws. So the government's economic ownership shall stay fully intact after such a conversion. But it will lose its voting rights. Thereby, it will allow the new controlling owner to take charge without the government coming in his or her way, without the government crimping his management in any way. And then slowly, the government should exit its stake over several years. Don't have to do it in one shot. Over several years, as the value of the company spikes under the new professional management. If you do this, then everybody would live happily ever after. और अगर यही विचार जो मैंने अभी आपके सामने रखे अंग्रेजी में आप हिंदी में सुनना चाहते हैं तो आप हमारी हिंदी क्विंट की YouTube चैनल पर जाइए और यही वीडियो आपको हिंदी में भी मिलेगा. एंड ऑफ कोर्स यू मस्ट नॉट फॉरगेट टू लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आवर YouTube चैनल राइट नाउ.